Built-in data structures in Python include lists, sets, and dictionaries. Also, in this video, we look at tuples. Let's have a look at tuple in code. When we run this, you can see a tuple. We can create a tuple with empty round brackets, and that will create a tuple, class tuple. Now we want to add some values, we can just add them. So here we've added x, y, and z with just a plus operator. So now we have a tuple of x, y, and z strings. Something we can do with tuples is unpack them. So here we have the tuple of x, y, and z, and we can put that into the three variables of a, b, c. So when we print that, we have a, which is x, b, which is y, and c equals z. Now, with a tuple, we can turn that into a string by using a join operator. So here we're joining x, y, and z with this dash. So when we run those four, we can see we have a class tuple. We have the tuple now of x, y, and z. We have the variables a, b, and c, which equal x, y, and z. So let's, if we change that to just print a, we have the value x, and we can use the join to make x, y, and z, the values in the tuple, to equal x dash y dash z, using the join to make the string x, y, and z. And tuples are not the same as lists, but they do share some common values and operations. So for example, we have this a tuple, and we can ask if a value is in that tuple. If we run that, we can see that x is in that tuple, so we can use in. We can use the same index, so if we print a tuple with the index 2, it's going to be z. We can use slicing, the same as the list, so here we have from 0 to 2, which is x and y. So we have the same slicing as we do in lists. And also count. We can use count to see how many values or how many times a value is inside a tuple. So there we have x is in a tuple once. There are differences between tuples and lists. And the main one is that tuples are immutable, meaning you can't just change the values. So the first item in a list or a tuple is at index 0. In a list, we could just change that very easily. But if we try that in a tuple, you'll see we get this error message. So tuple object does not support item assignment. Now, if you did want to change an item, what you can do is you can use slicing and then add the value that you wanted. So here we've got a tuple, x, y, and z. We're going to add all the items except for the first one to the new value, and that will create our a, y, and z. So that's the way to get around that. But the point is that tuples are immutable, meaning that you cannot change the value the same as you can a list. Another difference is the remove. In a list, you can remove a value, but again, if we run that in a tuple, you will see that tuple does not have remove. So we can have the solution to that is basically using a list. So here we have temp, we'll make the tuple into list, and then we can remove the value, and then we can change that list back to a tuple, and then we can print that. So here we have removed the value x from the tuple x, y, and z. We seem to be able to do a lot more with lists than we can tuples, so why use a tuple? Well, they're faster, so they're quite good for temporary variables, for example. So here we've got a tuple, and we can unpack that into variables. So we can use them for temporary variables. And here's an example where we have an email address and we can split that into a tuple with A and B. So we do have uses for tuples. Another area that you may see tuples use is in conjunction with other data structures. So here's an example of a tuple where we have 1A, 2B, 3C. Now we can print that into a list of unpacked 1, 2, 3 and ABC, which are both tuples inside a list. Now we can also create a dictionary from a tuple. So here's an example of the code for that. So we have the tuple A1, 2B, 3C, and then we can print the dictionary of those two values. So here we see the dictionary 1A, 2B, 3C as keys and values. And finally, we see an example where we have a dictionary and we want that to be printed in an order. So what we can do, we can change that. You can see here we've changed X is an actual list, but inside the list we have tuples. So here we have tuples of 2T, 4S, 5E. So we have the dictionary, but we've printed that in an order, the key order of 2, 4 and 5. So that's examples of how we might use tuples in association and with other types of data structures. Let's look at the practice exercises. We have exercise 1, create a dictionary from this tuple of 1A, 2B, 3C. Exercise 2, put this email address in a tuple using split, so two parts. Change tuple X to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So at the moment it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 4, 4. But you want to be able to print that as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Change it, then print it. Exercise 4, use zip to create a list of tuples. So we have A, B, C, D, E, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So you want a list of A1, B2, C3, D4, E and 5. Now exercise 5, use unzip to unpack a list of tuples. So before we have the list of tuples 1A, 2B, 3C, but after you've unpacked them, we have a list of a tuple 1, 2, 3 in a tuple ABC. That was exercise 5. Now let's look at the solutions. Let's go through the answers. So exercise 1, we created a dictionary from a tuple. Here we have a tuple of tuples 1A, 2B, 3C, and the code here, we create the dictionary from the X and Y temporary variables in a tuple. So we print that, we can see we've got 1A, 2B, 3C. So that's exercise 1. Exercise 2, we split the string into two parts using A and B. We can split that by the at symbol. That was exercise 2. Now exercise 3, we had X equals 1, 2, 3, 4, 4, 4, and we want to change that to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now we can't just change the values in the tuple because it's immutable. So what we can do is we can create a slice of X, as in X up to the full value, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then we add 5 and 6 tuple. So when we print X, we now have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So that was exercise 3. Now exercise 4, we had two lists. We've got A, B, C, D, E. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4. And we can run that. You can see we've got a list of the tuples A1, B2, C3, D4, E5. So that was exercise 4. Now finally we have exercise 5. And here we unpack the tuple of 1A, 2B, 3C. And when we run that, you can see we've got 1, 2, 3, A, B, C. So we do that using this star notation for unpacking. We are zipping the values and we're changing that into a list. If you want to improve your programming, then we suggest clicking the subscribe button, and if you click the notification bell, you'll know then when our new videos are released.